the solution to this example, first thing we're going to do is get it into Power Query. So we'll start with this one. And what we're going to say is data from table arrange. Okay, it's in. Let's just look at some of these. Balance looks fine. Date looks fine. So for now, we've got it in there. I'm just going to close it and load it to. And I'm just going to create a connection. When I say OK, you'll see we've got a name, table 27. I've created the connection. Let's go to this one now. I'm going to do the same thing, get it into Power Query. Okay, same thing, but remember what we said. This one here should be a negative sign. So we can do one of two things. We could create a formula, or we could go, let's go to transform, and we're going to say, please multiply that column by minus one. I'm going to say OK. You'll see it's now negative. And again, I'm just going to save and load two. And I'm going to make it a connection only. You'll see that's table 28. Now let's append them to each other. So under data, we go to get data. And you'll see when we go to combine queries, we had the option to merge. That's where we want to merge them together, or append them. So what we're going to do is we're going to click the append. What you asked, how many tables do you want to do? At the moment we know it's two. Primary table we're going to say is called table 27. Secondary is called table 28. So it's important you know the names of the ones you want. When I click OK, you'll see it goes through. And what it's now done is it's gone and put everything in. And notice the balance here. These are positive numbers, and these are negative numbers. So we've now appended these two lists, but made sure the signs work. And at this stage, we could then go close and load and get it into Excel to do whatever we need to do with it.